So good afternoon. So this session So Erode Sengund Engineering College provides a scheme for preparing SCST students for higher education under the scheme AICT Prerana. So myself Arun Prasad, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, and today in this class we will be discussing about Structural Engineering section. In that section we will be discussing some MCQs related to design of steel structures. Okay. So first one, so note it down. Select the correct statement. Material cost of rivet is higher than that of a bolt. Tensile strength of a bolt is lesser than that of a rivet. Bolts are used as a temporary fastening, whereas rivets are used as a permanent fastenings. And last one, riveting is less noisy than bolting. So it should be the correct answer. So you have to choose the correct one. So option A, material cost of rivet is higher than that of a bolt. So it is a wrong statement, because bolt is higher. Tensile strength of bolt is lesser than a rivet. So here it is also reciprocal. And last one, riveting is less noisy. While riveting will be having a noise because we will be having a tampering sound. So the correct answer will be the option C. Bolts are used as a temporary fastening, whereas rivets are used as a permanent fastening. Because for bolts we can unremove, this we can tighten it and we can remove it wherever and whenever necessary. But rivets, no, when we done the fastening, then we have to remove the whole thing again, we have to insert a new one. Okay, and second one, the forces acting on the web splice of a plate girder are axial force, shear and axial force, shear and bending, axial and bending. So we all know girders and especially plate girders. So in that, the web splice, you know, splice member. So what are the force will be acting in this? Only axial force or shear and axial, shear and bending, or axial and bending forces? So the answer will be shear forces and bending forces. Okay, note it down. The next one. Generally, the purlins are placed at the panel points so as to avoid axial force in rafter, shear force in rafter, deflection of rafter, bending moment in rafter. So in the roof structure, it is a roof member or in a truss members, especially in the industrial structures, the purlins will be placed in the longitudinal direction, right? The purlins, no? So why they are placing in that panel sections? So it is either to avoid axial force or shear force or deflection or bending moment. So since the rafter and the panel should not bend, if there is a truss, it also should not be bending, because all the load, wind load and every load will be acting at the nodal point. So everything will be transferred to the purlin and then next to the substructure. So here it will be bending moment. Option D is the answer. So next one, which of the following sections should be preferably used at places where torsion occurs? Angle section, channel section, box type, any of the above. So wherever the torsion occurs, no, the angle section it will be deflected, and channel section strength will be not be attained. So in box type, everything will be equal. So in case of the torsion, no, box tip section will be preferred. So next one. Other conditions being same, the load factor in indeterminate structure is. So every condition will be same, that is other conditions. The load factor in the indeterminate structure is equal to load factor in determinate structure, more than load factor in determinate structure, less than the load factor in determinate structure, unpredictable. So here the answer is option B. So here the load factor in indeterminate structure will be next one. Rivets connecting flange angles to cover plates in a plate girders are subjected to horizontal shear force only, vertical load only, both A and B, and none of the above. So the rivets that is connecting the flange angles to cover the plates in a plate girder. In the plate girder where the plates are placed, no? So in that area the flange angles are used rivet connection. So in such cases, what are the loading what it will be subjected to? Horizontal shear only, vertical load only, both A and B, none of the above. So in cover plate or flange angle will be subject to only horizontal shear. Okay. So next one, the effective length of a fillet weld should not be less than 2 times the weld size, 4 times the weld size, 6 times the weld size, and the same as the weld size. So the answer is B, it is 4 times the weld size. So next one, in a gusseted base, when the end of the column is measured for complete bearing on the base plate, then the axial load is assumed to transfer to be transferred to place plate. So I'll read it again. In a gusseted base, we are on gusset plate, no? So in such base, when the end of the column is measured for complete bearing on the base plate, then the axial load is assumed to be transferred to base plate fully by direct bearing, fully through fastenings, 50% by direct bearing and 50% through fastenings, 75% by direct bearing and 25% through fastenings. So here it will be 50% by direct bearing and 50% through fastening in case of gusseted base. So the axial load will be axial load that is transferring to the base plate, no? So 50% will be direct bearing and 50% will be in the through the connections, that is fastenings. So here I'll read the question. Ninth one, if the floor is supported at or near the bottom top chord of a bridge is not braced, then the bridge is called deck type, through type, half through type, double deck type. That is, I'll read it again. If the floor is supported supported at or near the bottom Okay, the floor is supported at or near the bottom, but the top guards of a bridge is not braced. Then the bridge is curled. It is a type of a half through bridges. Okay. Next one, the elastic strain for steel is about 1 by 12 of strain at the initiation of strain hardening and about 1 by 120 of maximum strain. 1 by 2 of strain at the initiation of strain hardening and about 1 by 12 of maximum strain. Option C, 1 by 12 of strain at the initiation of strain hardening and 1 by 200 of maximum strain. 1 by 24 of strain at the initiation of strain hardening and about 1 by 200 of maximum strain. So the option will be C. Okay, next one. In a virtual work method, the virtual quantity is displacement, load, slope, moment. So obviously the answer is the displacement. So next one. In moment resisting connections, the moment resistance of riveted connection depend upon shear in rivets, compression in rivets, tension in rivets, strength of rivets in bearing. So read the question again. In moment resistance structures, the moment resistance of riveted connection depend upon, what is the answer? So the answer is tension in rivets. So in moment resistance connection, now tension will play a major role. Next one. The portal bracing in a stress bridge is used to transfer load from top of end posting to bearing. Keep the rectangular shape of the bridge cross section. Stiffen the structure laterally. Prevent the sideways buckling of top guard. The portal bracing in a stress bridge is used to transfer the load from the top of end post to bearing. So that is the portal braces are used. So next one, the maximum permissible span of asbestos cement sheets is, so we can find it from the code book, that is the answer is 1680 mm. Next one, lacing bars in a steel column should be designed to resist bending moment to 2.5% of the column load, shear force due to 2.5% of the column load, 2.5% of the column load, or both A and B. So how the lacing bars in steel columns should be designed? So it should be designed to resist shear force due to 2.5% of the column load. Okay, next one.
the moment of the couple setup in a section of a beam by the longitudinal compressive and tensile force is known as bending moment, moment of resistance, flexural stress moment, none of this. So I'll read it again. The question: the moment of the couple setup in a section of a beam by the longitudinal compressive and tensile force is known as moment of resistance. Okay, the answer will be moment of resistance. So next one, the thickness of the web of a mild steel plate girder is less than d by 200. If only one horizontal stiffness are used, it is placed at where should the stiffness be used? So read the question again. Thickness of a web of a steel plate girder. So they are given the web thickness of a plate girder. It is less than the d by 200. If only one horizontal stiffness are used, where it will be placed? Whether it will be in the neutral axis, 2/3 of the depth of neutral axis from the compression flange, 2/5 of the depth of neutral axis from the compression flange, or 2/5 of the height of the neutral axis from the tensile flange. So the answer will be option C, 2/5 of the depth of the neutral axis from the compression flange. So shear buckling of a web in a plate girder is prevented. How the buckling can be prevented? By using vertical intermediate stiffener or horizontal stiffener at neutral axis, bearing stiffener, or none of the above. So the answer is option A. Okay, we'll move to next one. So I'm moving a little bit faster because lot of MCQs we have to cover it. So next one, the most commonly used section in lateral system to carry shear force in build-up columns. So what are the most common sections? Lateral sill flats, rolled angles, rolled channels, all the above. So everything will be used based on the usage. Next one, the stress in the wall of a thickness, sorry, stress in the wall of a thin cylinder subjected to internal pressure is hoop compression, shear, torsional shear, hoop tension. So the answer will be hoop tension. The risk coefficient K depends upon, that is, while you are calculating the wind load, no, the risk coefficient K value. So you can go to the code book for reference, wind load code book. The mean design, sorry, the mean probable design life of a structure, basic wind speed, both A and B, are another book. So it will be both A and B, that is option C. So we have to see the basic wind speed of a particular area for what we are going to find out. Okay, then mean design life of a structure. So we have to find out the K1 value at one and K2 value, basic wind speed. Sorry, it's not K2, it's basic wind speed. So next one, for eccentricity, sorry, for eccentrically loaded column, the bending factor is cross section area of column, radius of gyration, next one, radius of gyration, cross sectional area of column, option C, cross sectional area of column, section modulus of the section, option D, section modulus of section, cross sectional area of column. So don't confuse, for eccentrically loaded column, the bending factor. So what will be the bending factor here? that is cross-section area of column divided by section modulus. Okay. Next one. The net area of round bars to resist the tension. Is the area of cross section at midsection, root of the thread, difference of A and B, none of this. So the answer will be root of the thread. Okay. Note it down. So next one, the bracings between two columns of a steel tank will be designed to resist horizontal shear due to wind or earthquake only. Horizontal shear due to wind or earthquake plus 2.5% of column loads. Column loads plus 2.5% of horizontal shear due to wind or earthquake. Column loads plus full horizontal shear due to wind or earthquake. So the option is B, horizontal shear due to wind or earthquake plus 2.5 column loads, 2.5% of column loads. Next one, the column space is used to increase length of the column, strength of the column, cross sectional area of the column, none of this. So column space, it will be used for the increase in the length. So option A is the answer. Next one, a beam may be designed as a cased beam if the section is of double open channel from the web, from within the webs, not less than 40 mm apart. Overall depth and width of the steel sections do not exceed 750 and 450 mm respectively. Beam is solidly encased in concrete with 10 mm aggregate, having 20 degree strength, 160 kg per centimeter square, or all the above. So when we will be, a beam can be designed as a cased beam. The section is double open channel, that is webs will be not be less than 40 mm. Overall depth and width should not exceed 750 and 450. Next one, beam will be having a concrete with 10 mm aggregate and having a strength 160 kg per centimeter square after 28 days. So these three also combined together will be having a cased beam. In three cases also will be having, so option D will be the answer. Next one, the bracings provided in the plane of end post is called sway bracing, portal bracing, top bracing, top lateral bracing, bottom lateral bracing. So in the end post, no, the bracing that we provide is called portal bracing. So next one, in a build up beam, actual bending compressive stress, that is FBC, is given by, that is when Y1 is the distance of edge of the beam from the neutral axis. So from neutral axis, from the edge, you know, the distance is the Y1. So what will be the bending compressive stress, FBC, in a build-up beam? That is actual bending compressive stress. FBC equal to M by I, XX into Y1, FBC equal to IXX, that is necessary by M into Y1, FBC equal to IXX by M plus Y1 FBC equal to M by IXX plus Y1. So answer will be at option A. Next one, if the thickness of a sectional member is small as compared to its length and width, it is called, in the thickness of a structural member is small when compared to length and width. So read the question again. It is, the answer will be one dimensional or two dimensional, three dimensional, none of this. So they are given only the length and width. So you can assume from that even it is a two dimensional. Okay, so answer will be two-dimensional. The statistical method of plastic analysis satisfies equilibrium and mechanism conditions, equilibrium and plastic moment conditions, mechanism and plastic moment conditions, equilibrium conditions only. So the option will be equilibrium and plastic moment conditions. Okay. Okay, next one, the lug angles is used with a single angle member, not used with double angle member, used with a channel member, or all the above. So the answer will be option D, all the above. So next one, compression members composed of two channels back to back and separated by a small distance are connected together by riveting, so that the minimum slenderness ratio of each member between the connection does not exceed. So how much the connection should be slenderness ratio in between the connection, that is 40 or 50 or 60 or 70. The answer will be 40. So remember this. The connection, next one, the connection of intermediate vertical stiffener to the web not subjected to external loads shall be designed for a minimum shear force kilonewton per meter of 75 t square by h, 125 t cube by h square, 125 t square by h, 175 t square by h, where t is nothing but the thickness, web thickness. It is given in the mm value, and h is the outstand of that stiffness, that also in mm. So the answer will be option C, 125 t square by h. Okay, next one. When the upper column does not provide full bearing over, when the upper column doesn't provide full bearing area over lower column, the column space is provided with the following assumptions. So the assumptions are, bearing plate is assumed as a short beam to transmit the axial load to the lower column section. Okay, next one. Axial load is assumed to be taken as flanges. Load transmitted from the flanges of the upper column and the reactions from the flanges of lower column are equal and form a couple or all the above. So read it again. When the upper column does not provide full bearing area over the lower column, the columns, so while we are providing the column space, what are the assumptions to be provided? So when we are providing the column space, in this condition, when the upper ground does not provide the full bearing area. So the answer will be the everything. So option A and B and C. Okay. That is option D will be the answer here. Okay, next, the last one of the session. for the economical decision of a combined footing to support two equal column loads, the projections of beam in lower tire are kept such that bending moment under column is equal to bending moment at the center of the beam, half the bending moment at the center of the beam, twice the bending moment at the center of the beam, or none of this. So for the economical design of a column combined footing to support two equal columns loads, the projections of the beams in the lower tire are kept in such that the bending moment under column is equal to, so bending moment at the center of the beam. So the answer is bending moment at the center of the beam. Okay. Okay. So with this we will be stopping today's session. So I hope everyone understood in today's class about that MCQs regarding steel structures. So in the upcoming classes we can discuss further topics more in detail in steel structures. So these MCQs you have to go through again and again so that it will be able to, you can able to practice it. Okay then. So we'll wind up the session, and in the next further classes we'll be discussing the remaining. Okay. Thank you.